Good afternoon and welcome to Thinking About the Bible, and we are in Colossians chapter 4, yeah, verse 1. And we're going to just look at verse 1 because it starts a whole new thought after that. And this actually, verse 1 of chapter 4 is kind of a continuation where Paul is talking about domestic issues, husbands, wives, children, bondservants. Now he's talking about masters. And he says in verse 1 of chapter 4, I don't know why I'm getting my chapters and verses mixed up this morning. Masters, give your bondservants what is just and fair, knowing that you also have a master in heaven. And that's all we're going to look at this morning. But as with the bondservants, this principle of how masters should treat their slaves, I think we can take that principle, and again, without going into all the exegesis and theological bridge building that we would do here, it's really pretty simple, that people who someone might have in their charge, as in this case it was servants or slaves. In our case, we're talking about employers talking about their employees. Give them what is just and fair. Now, when we talk about wages and stuff these days, and is it just, what is a just wage? What is a fair wage? And there's a lot of discussion on the left and the right about that. Should there be a minimum wage and that kind of thing? And I guess what I would say is that from a biblical standpoint, what is just and fair would have to be determined by local circumstance. So in the area that I live, wages seem to be a little depressed, a little bit low. A just and fair wage would be something that would allow your employee to take care of their needs. Now, that's going to vary as well. You might have a kid who's got their very first job. They work at, you know, some place flipping burgers or whatever. They don't have to have a wage that is going to enable them to have a house and care for a wife and kids and so forth. It's their first job. They might be 16 years old or whatever, and they're flipping burgers for, you know, whatever wage. The problem is we live in a society where the employer is not allowed to do what is just and fair. He has to follow certain laws. It has to pay a minimum wage, for instance. And he has to do things according to, he can't discriminate and say to the 16-year-old, well, I'm not going to pay you as much doing the same job as the 40-year-old who lost his job someplace. Now he's here trying to make a living, doing the best he can to support a wife and a few kids or whatever. To do what's just and fair, it takes wisdom. And an employer who is going to be biblically correct, doing what they should do, isn't going to pay the same wage to everybody. Just because, even if they do the same job. And I know this sounds controversial, but you think about the parable of the vineyard workers, where Jesus paid some people, or not Jesus, but the man of the parable. But of course, when we apply that parable to our walk with Christ and the theological implications of that, ultimately, that's the Lord and his giving of reward. But the owner of the vineyard paid the same wage to someone who worked much less than the guy who started at the beginning of the day. Now, that principle, you might pay a higher wage to somebody who does the same amount of work, you see. So that's kind of the same idea. So for a master to give an employer to give an employee what is just and fair requires that he not be forced by some civil authority or anything else to do something. There's a standard. That's how the ungodly approach things. Everything's the same, and that's not true. Not everything is the same, and the employer should be able to do what is just and fair, knowing that he has a master in heaven. Because ultimately, he doesn't answer to the civil authority, he doesn't answer to the church, he doesn't answer to anybody, but he ultimately answers to God, and he needs to do what's just and fair. And unfortunately, we live in a society that is difficult to do. So think about that today, what it is in our nation, specifically, that keeps us from doing what is just and fair on a daily basis. We'll see you again tomorrow.